Hi, this is Sage of the Stage. I'm a singing professor and a musician, and if this is your first time on the channel, welcome. Today, I'm going to listen to a song called Kickapoo, and that's just the best title of the song ever. And I've actually watched this movie. It's from a movie called The Pick of Destiny, but I watched it like, I can't even remember when. I was very young, which is kind of weird because it's a freaking insane movie. I think I was in my primary school, you know? I was very young, so about 20 years, maybe a bit less, but around that time. So it was a while ago. I remember some of the songs, but I don't remember every single detail. And I want to check out this song, analyze it a bit, talk about vocal things, about musical things, and I hope to take you on a journey. This song is sung by three amazing frontmen, amazing singers, Dio, Jack Black, and Meat Loaf, who passed away recently. And that's another reason why I really wanted to check out this song, because at a time when I first listened to this song, like ages ago, I didn't even know that this was Meat Loaf, because my first association with Meat Loaf was always, you know, I would do anything for love. And there he looked completely different. He had makeup on. He looked more like a Phantom of the Opera kind of deal than just being himself, you know, without a makeup. So that was my bad. I didn't know that at the time. But with everything that I've learned across the years, I want to check out this song properly. So let's go check it out together. Oh yeah, and just a quick disclaimer, parental warning, whatever you want to call it. This song has a lot of cursing in it. And I mean, a lot. So just a fair warning. And let's go.
Fucking time ago in a town called Kickapoo, there lived a humble family, religious through and through. But yay, there was a black sheep, and he knew just what to do. His name was Young JP, and he refused to step in line. A vision he did see, it fucking rocking all the time. He wrote a tasty jam, and all the planets did align.
Okay, so this first part is sung by Young Jack Black, basically. He's actually singing the role of his young self, and it makes sense, you know. But the thing that I really appreciate about this part is that he makes his voice sound younger. He just doesn't go over the top with aggressive singing. He's singing very softly, and it's kind of thinner, not the voice that he usually uses, you know, when singing live, when he's over the top, you know, the way we like him. He's just a very amazing frontman. He's very energetic. Here, he's holding it back a bit for the sake of the character. But let's listen one more time. There are a couple of details that I really enjoy how he sings. First of all, his pronunciation is over the top good. Like, it's so good. I mean, if I were to listen to this in a very noisy room, I would not have a single trouble understanding him. And that's something that I really appreciate. That's not something that I can say about many singers. But Kickapoo.
A long ass fucking time ago in a town called Kickapoo, there lived a humble family, religious through and through.
For example, listen to that through and through. The way he really uses that T sound, that's so good and so frontal, Kickapoo, beautiful.
There lived a humble family, religious through and through. But yay, there was a cool black sheep, and he knew just what to do.
And even this, like, the rhyming with through is do. And he does a bit of a glissando, but it's kind of a stylistic, because he's a sassy kid. He's really, you will just hear it in a second. And even in his singing, you can kind of, well, maybe anticipate what's going to happen just a bit by his style. He's, you know, he doesn't give a shit about anybody, basically.
But yay, there was a black sheep, and he knew just what to do.
You know, that little slide.
His name was Young JP, and he refused to step in line. A vision he did see, a fucking rock.
And even the way he curses, I mean, sorry about it. Listen to the word he says. Listen to the way he says, you know? He's really through his teeth and just kind of full of anger.
To step in line. A vision he did see, a fucking rocking all the time. He wrote a tasty jam and all the planets did align.
Align. Great.
Oh, the dragon's balls ablaze, and as I stepped into
The thing that I'm going to say is not a vocal thing. I mean, I'm going to talk about music in general as well. The rhythm guitar, the way he plays the guitar, and the way he changes the rhythm patterns. So good. It just fits the mood of the character so much. And let's go listen to this part one more time. I feel like the first part that he's singing and this part is almost like two different characters. The first one was definitely more, let's say, in a praying manner, although badass, but lightly. You know, it was sung lightly, but here he was more like, let's say, more like the Jack Black we know today. That's kind of how I think about it. Let's listen to it one more time.
The planets did align. Oh, the dragon's balls were blazing as I stepped into his cave.
Definitely a bit more grit.
With a long and shiny blade. Twas I who fucked the dragon, fuck a licing, fuck a loo. And if you try to fuck with me, then I shall fuck you too.
And I don't know why, but Meat Loaf is smiling here. Like, it's almost like he approved the song up until this point.
If you try to fuck with me, then I shall fuck you too.
Right? That's so good. Ah, man. I mean, this is not even funny. He's a kid, and I kind of understand this because I, first of all, am a Catholic, and I grew up in a Catholic family, but all of us are musicians. And trust me, all of us like rock. I mean, we've kind of, maybe that's, I don't know, some people think like that's weird, but rock is just great music, not just rock, metal, you know, heavy music. Music is good music, you know, there is nothing bad about it. So being satanic, I mean, let's be real, there are some bands that, you know, write lyrics that are kind of satanic. For example, I would say that band, Him, the singer is Willie Vallow, is more satanic than, let's say, AC/DC. Just compare their lyrics to Rip Out the Wings of the Butterfly, for example, and any AC/DC songs. I mean, you know, but that's completely a different topic. Good music, heavy music is just good music, you know? And I don't know, let's listen to this part. Sorry for rambling a bit.
Music that you play for us comes from the depths of hell. Rock and roll's the devil's work, he wants you to rebel. You become a mindless puppet, the Elzebub will pull the strings. Your heart will lose direction, and chaos it will bring. You better shut your mouth, you better watch your tone. You got a four week with no telephone.
So one thing that I kind of realized only now, I've watched this whole movie, as I already said, when I was about 7, 8, which is not the best time in my life to watch this movie, but okay. And that time I didn't really, I just listened to it and I watched it. I didn't really think about it too much, but now I understand that this is basically kind of like a rock musical in a way, and it sounds beautiful. And at the same time, Meat Loaf is a king of rock opera, and his voice is just like a volcano. The dude is an incredible singer, and I watched a video recently by a YouTuber that I really appreciate, Mary Spender, who said that when he was starting out, a lot of these publishers didn't really believe in him because he was writing these songs that were structured very differently from rock songs or pop songs at the time. Somebody said to him basically like, are you insane? You're writing songs that have A, B, C, F, G parts, you know, too many parts, and you're trying to put them on radio. That just doesn't work because songs that are played on the radio are usually, let's say, A, B, A, B, C, B. B being the chorus, A being the verses, you know, C being a bridge, if there even is a bridge. So Meat Loaf is a great example. If you're doing something that you really feel is worthy, if you really think it's good, and you're putting in the hours and everything, then you need to do it. You need to do it no matter what everybody says. And a lot of people really rejected him, especially in America. I think that he first started being famous in UK. So it doesn't matter where you start. Somebody, if your music is good, will understand it. And after that, people will probably go, okay, maybe he has something. But Meat Loaf, not only does he have something, he has everything. He's amazing, and I watched his live performances on YouTube. Dude has so much energy. He's jumping around, crazy, sweaty, but he's not stopping. From start to finish, his performance, you can write books about it. He's just an amazing frontman, brutally good singer, and we're going to listen to this part one more time. And we finally have distortion here. You disobeyed my orders, son, why were you never born? Your brother's 10 times better than you, Jesus loves him more. But he freaking flips the cross. That's like the coolest part. Music that you play for us comes from the depths of hell. Rock and roll's the devil's work. He wants you to rebel. But this part. You become a mindless puppet. The survivor pulls free. I mean, that distortion, that kind of aggressive singing. And you can basically hear him singing through his teeth. Because he's singing like this, you know? He's not even opening his mouth at some parts. Because it fits the character. He's angry. And this is not something that everybody can do. He basically has that kind of theatrical approach, and he has that in his own music as well. But this is just, this is so good. Just listen to the mindless, sorry for pausing this part. Mindless. You know? So a couple of parts. We have kind of a word painting here thing where he says Beelzebub will pull strings, and then he pulls this, I don't know, some kind of, what was that? Some kind of doll out of the ceiling. Dragon. I think that's a dragon. One other amazing vocal thing that he does here is basically like a contrast. He's singing basically all of it very gritty and very through his teeth and just, you know? But this part where he says chaos it will bring, he softens it up. He kind of almost whispers it. And usually in psychology, when you're talking and you want to reach many people. You want to say something, and you're playing with your dynamics. So sometimes you're going to say something louder, sometimes you're going to say something quieter, but when you whisper something, that usually means that it's more important. This is just a small part of psychology explaining how we accept information. So just listen to his general singing, and then listen to that part, chaos it will bring. Definitely a big contrast. Devil's work, he wants you to rebel. You become a mindless puppet. The survivor, you know? Strings. Your heart will chaos it will bring. Ooh. You better shut your mouth, you better watch your tone. I love these fills. You got a phone weak with no telephone. Boom. And that's another thing, like those glissandos downwards. Basically just saying him, you're gonna be grounded, you're going down. And he's basically doing that with his voice as well. So it's also kind of a word painting thing. Don't let me hear you cry, don't let me hear you moan. Again, the endings. And the door shuts, and everything stops. Dio, can you hear me? I am lost and so alone. I'm asking for your guidance. Won't you come down from your throne? I need a tight compadre who will teach me how to rock. My father thinks you're evil, but man, he can suck a cock. Rock is not the devil's work. It's magical and rad. I'll never rock as long as I am stuck here with my dad. Ooh. Ooh. So this part, again, is sung by Jables, let's say, the young JB, Jack Black. And it's amazing how he can switch from being also very good at pronunciating, aggressive singing, and, you know, being a very, I would say, extrovert. You know, I feel like Jack Black is an extrovert, and that's kind of you can hear that in his voice as well. But here he's singing again very lightly, very softly. It's like he can dial it back. Like I could say that he's singing this with maybe 20% of his voice tops. You know, he's not even pushing it, he's not doing anything too big, but it fits the character so much. And I love these couple of rhymes and a couple of details. I'm gonna stop it here and there just to show you. Dio, can you hear me? I am lost.
lost and so alone.
Very pretty.
I'm asking for your guidance. Won't you come down from your throne?
I really like that throne.
Asking for your guidance. Won't you come down from your throne? I need a tight compadre who will teach me how to rock. My father thinks you're evil, but man, he can suck a cock.
Best part.
The devil's work, it's magical and rad. I'll never rock as long as
this.
I am stuck here with my dad.
So basically, he's there preparing for this strong rock part. So he's very going a bit more nasally, and he's really focusing his tone. It's a going from a bit more wider tone to a bit more frontal and forward, and you know, almost like, well, aggressive again, you know. Listen to the last sentence.
I'll never rock as long as I am
now?
Stuck here with my dad.
Again, soft but very focused. Beautiful.
Jables, you are hungry for the rock, but to learn the ancient methods, secret doors you must unlock. Escape your father's clutches and this oppressive neighborhood. On a journey you must go to find the land of Hollywood.
Ooh, hell yeah.
In the city of fallen angels, where the ocean meets the sand, you will form a strong alliance.
Ooh.
And the world's most awesome brand.
Okay, let me pause it here because Dio's part is over. Why don't I listen to Dio more? I mean, I'm gonna be completely honest with you. I don't know too many Dio songs. Should we change that? Should I react to something from Dio? Because the dude is a god. Ah! You know, he's a vocal god. First of all, that one vibrato that he does, so good.
Jables, you are hungry for the rock, but to learn the ancient methods, secret doors you must unlock.
So even his pronunciation is definitely different from JB's and Meatloaf's. His is more spitty because you can hear it like, I hear you, brave young Jables, you are hungry for the rock. Rock. You know, he's almost like spitty, dear, but that's just his style and it serves him right.
Hungry for the rock, but rock. To learn the ancient methods, secret doors you must unlock.
So basically, almost like using a bit of that. So basically, using a bit of fry there to get that kind of rah sound.
Before the rock, but to learn the ancient methods, secret doors you must unlock. Escape your father's clutches in this oppressive neighborhood. On a journey you must go to find the land of Hollywood.
Ooh, that's a beautiful vibrato. Just that part. Ooh.
In the city of fallen angels, where the ocean meets the sand, you will form a strong alliance.
Ooh, strong alliance. Just those two words are sung more strong, with more grit and more distortion. He's doing it on purpose to emphasize the word strong alliance, because that's very important for the song.
Meets the sand, you will form a strong alliance.
Ooh.
And the world's most awesome brand.
Awesome. Came and filmed. The way he jumps. This is a badass song.
So Bill from fucking Kickapoo, with hunger in his heart, and he journeyed far and wide to find the secrets of his art. But in the end, he knew that he would find his counterpart.
Very Jack Black kind of thing to do.
Yeah.
Okay, so this last part kind of even reminds me of Search from System of a Down, the way, let's say, the way that he would maybe sing it. Not this first part, but the ending. This is Jack Black, definitely. And he journeyed far and wide to find the secrets of his art. But in the end, he knew that he would find his counterpart. But I can hear this part also sung by Serge. A bit of falsettos, or soft, or let's say head voice. And then going wider, kind of a bit more operatic. But this part, I can definitely hear Serge doing this as well. Yeah. Ooh. So what can I say? This, first of all, is an incredible song. This is a great rock song. And it's definitely written in a rock musical kind of sense because it has a lot of parts. The words of the song are very important for the whole plot of the movie and just important in general for the song. So many cool details of the song that I hope you appreciate even more now. For every Meat Loaf fan out there, to his family, my sincere condolences. He's definitely a voice that will be missed so much. And I'm just glad that he shared his music with the world because, as I understand, he was a very shy character off stage. So I'm very glad that he shared his music because the world would be just a very poor place without it. And his job on this song and Dio's and Jack Black, this song is just a killer. This is basically a classic, I should say. If you enjoyed this video, remember to share it around, subscribe, like, leave a comment. I would like to hear your thoughts and let me know if I should check out any other songs from any of these guys. You look wonderful and I do hope to see you in the next video. Bye.